Hi everyone, it's Yanis here. Today we'll take a look at the Kevin Kruse book called 15 Secrets Successful People Know About Time Management. This book reveals secrets of time management used by 7 billionaires, 13 Olympic athletes, 29 straight-A students, and 239 entrepreneurs. So without further ado, let's dive in. Number 1, time is your most valuable asset. Most importantly, it is critical to realize that your time is your most valuable asset. And once it's gone, you can never get it back. I like to share one tip from Bill Gates to emphasize this point. He says, don't waste time to have more time. Everyone wants to have more time, but we all have it. The difference is that some people invest their time in meaningful activities, while others waste their time. Come on, it doesn't make sense to watch TV for 3 hours and then say, oh, I wish I had more time. For what? To watch more TV? Number 2, prioritization. If you do the right things, then 24 hours is enough. The problem why most of the people run out of the time is because they're doing the wrong things. That's why you have to focus on MITs, or most important tasks that will help you to move forward in life. And not all tasks will help you to do that. Watching TV, for example, will not help you much with anything. If your goal is to develop a mobile app, then your MIT could be to hire a programmer or project manager who will handle the operations to develop the app. When you don't waste your time on activities that have very little value, you suddenly find that you actually have quite a bit of a time every day. Number 3, ditch to-do list and use calendar. There is a better way of planning than just making unlimited to-do lists. Many people think that managing time using to-do lists is the only way, but that of course is not true. There are different ways and better ways to do that. And one of the approaches is called time blocking. Time blocking focuses on creating daily structure instead of individual tasks. To start time blocking, you can simply use Calendar Planner. Block out your time for your MITs and stick with your structure. You can also use digital planners like Google Calendar or even time blocking applications that will enable you to receive notifications when time block is starting and finishing. Number 4, overcome procrastination. You can use pleasure and pain principles to overcome it. Procrastination is a huge obstacle when it comes to time management and productivity, and no one is protected against it. Sometimes, when things are going well, you might think that you have won against the procrastination, but then the situation changes and it comes back again. Next time, when you face procrastination, you can try to use pleasure and pain principles to overcome it. If your goal is to exercise and you procrastinate to hit the gym, then you can imagine yourself 3 months later with a big beer belly and feeling sluggish. And then imagine yourself 6 months later when you are on holiday near a beach in a great physical condition with a lot of energy. Number 5, there will be always more to do. You have to understand that there will be always more to do, and that's okay. Many people feel that they have to deal with everything in their life, and that's why they always feel overwhelmed with the things to do. You simply have to understand that there will be always more things to do. Once you understand this principle, life becomes easier to manage. Number 6, make sure you write things down. Having written notes will help you to manage your time. I like to think that I can remember many things, but the fact is that I often forget. And I'm sure that many people are same as me. Solution is simple, just write things down and you'll not have to think about them. I like to use my notebook for that, but you can use notes on your phone or anything else. Number 7, avoid checking email. It's not like email is bad, but you don't have to check it 20 times per day. It's a huge time waster. Email is like slot machine. You check it because you think something is going to be there. And sometimes there is. Bingo, you just got distracted from whatever else you was doing. Limit your email checks to a couple of times per day on a certain times and make sure you don't check it in the mornings. Number 8, avoid meetings. Having occasional meetings is great, but don't get trapped in them. Purpose of the meetings is to make a decision based on available information, but if left uncontrolled, meetings can be a huge time waster. You got to find a balance, and if you feel that meetings are not productive and you spend a lot of time on them, then you have to start to avoid them. Number 9, say no. I guess this does not require extended explanation or samples. Every time you don't say no, you're taking your time out of your existing activities. And once you have too many things on your plate, you can't finish any of them. Number 10, use 80-20 principle. Focus on most important activities. 80-20 rule can be applied to every area of your life. It states that 80% of the results come from 20% of actions. So instead of giving all the activities the same levels of energy, you should prioritize the most important activities. Number 11, delegate. This is the best way to multiply your time. Delegation will help you to get more done with extra resources. This in turn will free your hands to do more important activities or to have free time for yourself. You can start with delegating your administrative tasks to personal assistant, as they are usually simply to delegate. And once you are more confident, you can also delegate your creative work. Number 12, batching or theming. You should have a theme for each day to be more productive and batch similar tasks together. I have been utilizing theming for a month now, and my productivity has increased since. Tuesdays and Thursdays are always my content production days. Mondays, Wednesdays and Fridays are my app development days, and on Saturdays I do my strategic planning and admin work. Having a theme for each day puts me in the right mindset, and I'm more productive that way. So you should definitely give theming a try. Number 13, immediately complete tasks that take less than 5 minutes to do. Most of our to-do lists are way too long with the little tasks. That's why tip number 13 is to complete little tasks straight away without even putting them down on to-do list. Number 14, have a morning routine. Having a morning routine will ensure that you start your day on the right foot. This is a habit of all ultra-successful people. They all have morning routines. They exercise, read, and plan their day. So there is no excuse why you shouldn't have one as well. Do what motivates you in the morning and you'll find it easier to wake up every day. Number 15, energy management. It's not really the time that you have to manage, but it is your energy. Time will keep going on its own pace, no matter what. What you have to pay attention to is where you invest your energy. You can only achieve those things where you invest your energy. Also, be aware that everyone in this world will want your attention and energy, so you have to be smart about how you use it. If you want to manage your time better, have more structure in your life, and achieve your goals, make sure you check out my time planning application. You can set goals and track progress towards them, create time blocks and build your own daily structure, as well as log your time and measure your performance. Best of all, it's totally free. So press here to check it out right now. I'm working on new videos every day, so be sure you subscribe so you don't miss my next episode.